I'm Erin Lawler Patterson, the goodness chick. I'm an international speaker, podcaster, counselor, author, and proud part of the Mental Health News Radio Network. Join me on the journey of empowering you to live life with an overflowing cup rather than an empty one. We look at mental health, self-care, addiction, relationship, and wellness, where we use our challenges to fuel us rather than consume us.
Today's episode, how to not control what you can't control. I don't know about you, whether you're type A or type B personality, but the past few months have been exceptionally stressful, and there's so many things that are simply out of our control. And if this is something that's been applicable to your own life, hold on for a super awesome episode. Now, before we jump in, if you have not already ordered your own copy of Conversations for Good, Listening and Learning from Our Neighbors Around the World, I hope you'll hop on Amazon and you'll order your copy. So if you're looking for something to just get you inspired, uplifted, and encouraged, check it out. It's my third book about our 10-month journey around the world in pursuit of kindness, interviewing and connecting with humans around the world who are changing the world through their actions and their mindset. And right now, what a beautiful way to be reminded of how beautiful the people around us are and how similar rather than different we are in so many different ways, and the domino contagious effect of kindness and giving back. Conversations for Good, Listening and Learning from Our Neighbors Around the World. So the past few months have been nothing short of extremely stressful. And it seems like normalcy in every sense of the word has kind of been pitched out the window. And I'm beginning to kind of digest that. And as we here in Florida, the first day of school was Monday. I started homeschooling my son about 2 weeks ago. Things have been interesting, would kind of be the word to connect this to. But what I've learned more than anything is allowing myself as I begin the day, taking a deep breath, starting in prayer, quiet time, and acknowledging the fact that there's so many things right now as I enter my day that I simply can't control. And what has really stuck with me more than it has, I will say, ever before in my life has really been the Serenity Prayer. And for those of you who aren't familiar with it, I'm going to repeat it. I love it. It's beautiful. It exudes truth and our reality right now. And it's, God grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. And I'm going to say that again. I was going to say sing. I don't want to scare you and frighten you. God grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. So how do I do that? There are things when it comes to what you have to deal with at work that are out of your control. Your kids going back to school, whether that's virtually or it's entering a school's doors. So I'll say myself with my husband beginning at the school year as a teacher, there's so many things right now that are within our reach, but we cannot touch because we can't control them. And so we can give ourselves our emotions, I'll say, the permission to kind of be consumed by that, brought down by that, depleted of energy by that, or we can allow it to be something, a reality that we digest and say, acknowledging every single day, there are things I can't control. And how that connects to our mental wellness and our mental health is the fact of us not striving to be in control of everything, not us trying to have everything right now what it was a year ago or 7 months ago, because the reality is we can't. So I want to look at today a few tips and strategies for you and myself, because I'm applying all this stuff to myself, to get through the next few months, years, our life in a way of acknowledging, yo, I cannot control everything. And I don't know what you believe. I know for me, my faith is a massively strong rooted part of my existence. I know there's things I'm just not in control of. I have made a conscious decision and effort that I do struggle with every day, but working on giving God the control of things, because if I try to control things, I know myself, I get extremely anxious. I go crazy. I get frustrated. I beat myself up emotionally, and it's unnecessary. So looking at today, how can I work on strengthening my ability to just, whoa, I realize I'm not in control of everything. So the first thing, which is a big thing, is learning to live in the now, the present. When we get fixated on past and present, kind of like this very sticky web of our life where we fixate on things that have happened in the past that we are frustrated about. Well, you can't change the past. There's no rewind button. And the future of, well, what's next month going to be like for my kid, next week for school, next tomorrow with my job, relationships, our mind can spin out of control because we cannot change everything. We are not in control of everything. And when we get lost head above water with past and future, it puts us in some really nothing but negative, nothing but anxiety provoking, emotional drainage, and we need to avoid it. So how the heck do I live in the present? It's allowing ourselves to stop when we start letting our minds veer off to either past or future. I'm in the now. And with right now, no matter how crazy it is, what am I grateful for right now? Bringing our mind back. And that is going to be really, really hard initially, but it is fully possible. So focusing and living in the present, because when we let our minds weave and roam to past or future, particularly future right now with everything going on in the world, we lose the battle. We become less of who we were intended to be. We become tired and we become less effective in every other aspect of our lives. The next one that I'm going to look at and jump with you, looking at what do I actually have control over right now? What do I have control over? And looking at jotting that down a little bit and learning to be good with that, right? I'm in control in the morning of, you know, what I have my kid eat breakfast, lunch, and dinner, right? I have control of that right now. That won't be obviously forever. You know, I have control of what I'm doing with my business. There's factors within my business that I don't have control of, right? Right now, I normally would be out speaking at a lot of places, doing assemblies. That's not happening right now with the coronavirus. I have learned to kind of give that up big time, because if I beat myself up for it or think, oh my gosh, what isn't happening? What does that get me? I can't change the fact that we're in the middle of a pandemic. Can't change it, not able to. So saying, what am I in control of? And there's nothing wrong with even saying, like, what am I not in control of, right? And writing it down. And whether it's taking time to just take some deep breaths, praying over it, God, give me the ability to be at peace with what's going on of what I'm not in control of, because it's going to drive me crazy. It's going to make me overly anxious. It's putting me in a not good place. Praying about it and asking for patience and asking for peace. Peace is super, super big time right now. Super big time. Another one that's really, really important is being fair to ourselves in terms of our expectations. In terms of our expectations that we are doing more than we realize we are doing. And what does that mean? Because if we look at where we believe we are falling short personally, oh my gosh, I'm not, you know, at the end of the day, we're eating leftovers, or I just didn't put all the laundry away, or professionally, oh my gosh, I didn't get that stuff, you know, up to the standards I would normally do. Or, you know, I've not been working out like I used to 5 days a week. It's 3 days a week, or whatever it is, whatever, fill in the blank. If we focus on where we're falling short in the midst of some really, really trying times, it beats us up. So instead, what are you really doing? You ate dinner last night, rock on, right? You went for a walk around your block. That's super awesome. Writing down, what did you accomplish? Are you alive right now? Asking you that question. Do you have a pulse? Rock on, you're alive. And you could say, well, that's ridiculous. Well, but it's not. When we look at the past, right, of what we used to be seven months ago to now, you will 100% fall short. Instead of saying, what are the little wins? What are the little big wins that have been accomplished today, yesterday? And is there room for improvement? Yeah, but get in line, because you're human. If we compare ourselves to who we were, or we compare ourselves to the people around us that we think that, you know, I'll even say on social media that, you know, nothing's perfect, but people are depicting that because that's what we do, right? Nobody, I'm not showing a picture of me with my super scary hair in the morning, what I look like right before a cup of coffee or after I had, you know, a super gnarly run or workout. It's most of the time, everything's polished. It's just what we do. The reality, life isn't polished. and allowing yourself to kind of give yourself kudos for the now. What did you accomplish today? And when we write that down and boost ourselves, I'll say, it does really good things. It gives us those positives. It gives us those positives. A next one I'm moving on to, we just got three more, trying to keep a sense of structure and schedule that works for the present time. Structure and schedule, really important. Structure and schedule looks different than it did 6.5, 7 months ago, but getting some consistency, you know, getting up and you're having your breakfast, or, you know, you're getting this done with work, or you're there. The structure and schedule can be reformatted, can be reshaped, but it's still having something that, you know, creates within our mind that consistency, that what I know what to expect of what I can expect, because there's a lot of things that I can't expect within the course of the day. And I think you'll follow me with that one. When we can do what we can do with what we have, creating that structure, creating that schedule within the frame of what we can control, it gets our brain in the state of anticipating things that are consistent. And it makes that which is inconsistent consistently less intense and taxing emotionally. Moving on, two more, keeping connections with people. Even as many of us are kind of getting back to with work, or you've been working, maybe reconnecting with friends to some degree, human connection is important. Who your tribe is not just important, it's critical. Having people that support you, provide positive encouragement, are uplifting, realistic, and hold you accountable, but we need our peeps. When we become emotional islands in times like this, it's kind of easy to become an emotional island, fighting that tug, fighting that pull. And maybe it's, you know, asking for help. Hey man, can we FaceTime once a week? You know, can we go for a walk wherever you're walking and frolicking? Human contact is important. I even say within FaceTime, being able to see somebody else's, pupils, eye to eye contact makes a difference. It lets us reaffirms that we, are less alone, because we are not supposed to go at life by ourselves. Human connections, massive, massive, massive importance. Last one that I've been talking a whole lot about these past few months, self-care. Get it on, right? And whatever that means for you, taking care of yourself, because when we fill our cup and we take time for ourselves, when things are out of our control and we're acknowledging it, it seems less intensified. Our minds and bodies and spirits need to be pursued in terms of getting fed properly with our health. It's important. Is it always easy? Absolutely not. But holding ourselves a priority that allows us to be our cup fuller, us as human beings in an emotionally better place, and in turn, us being able to serve and love and care for the people around us in every aspect of our lives. What does self-care look like? Doesn't mean, you know, you necessarily have to go get a pedicure every, you know, third week. If you do, rock on, get bedazzled and all that jazz. But it could be something as easy as releasing our mind and decluttering our mind, helping that with getting enough sleep, right? When we're sleep deprived, it has an impact on our quality of life, our day-to-day. It affects us emotionally and mentally, absolutely. Limiting social media, whether it be the news that you're tuning into, to different social media platforms like Instagram, Snapchat, whatever the heck it is, right? Facebook, there's a whole lot of negativity going on right now that it's being informed, it's being alert, it's being aware, but not being saturated. Saturation doesn't do anything positive. Doesn't, wears you down. So monitoring, limiting it, balancing it. Exposure to just being outside, getting some sun, getting some exercise, moving your body, getting the blood pumping. All these things connect to our mental wellness that allows us to think clearer, be less stressed, and in turn, be in a spot that we can really begin to face and say, you know what, I'm not just saying this, but I'm believing that there's things that I can't control, what I can't control. And ending this today with the serenity prayer again, and saying it with all sincerity. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. Cling to that, my friends, because we can't be in control of everything that we can't control. And it's learning to just be okay with that, acknowledge it, and allow that instead of being an obligation or a burden, but a gift to lighten our load. and to fly higher than we've ever flown before. And so today I'm wishing you a tremendous amount of peace, love, and goodness, my friends.
If you enjoyed today's episode, there's a lot more encouragement and life-kicking strategies on goodnesschick.com. Have a great day, my friends.